Hi, my name's Phillip Slater, and this is the second in a series of videos where I'm talking about my book, Spare Parts Inventory Management. Now, if you're just joining us at this point, this book explains the requirements for managing spare parts inventory throughout its entire life cycle. And in this video, I'm going to talk about part one of the book, which is about establishing a spare parts inventory management system. So what does that require? Well, the first thing you need if you're going to manage spare parts inventory is you need to understand why spare parts inventory management is different to other types of inventory. In spare parts inventory, this is the inventory that's used for maintenance and operation support. It has characteristics that make it quite different from the inventory you may have at a big retail outlet or in a wholesale business. So at the start of the book, I explain these differences because it's really important to understand if you're going to have better spare parts inventory management. Now, the other thing you've really got to understand is finances, because it's all about money, right? So in the book, I explain the financial side of spare parts inventory management. What does it mean for your profit and loss? What is the balance sheet? How does that operate? What's happening with your operating statements? How does it affect your budget? How are all those things linked together? So I explain the financial side of spare parts inventory management. Then for the management of your parts, you're going to need to establish policies and procedures. You're going to need to be able to guide the decision making. You're going to be able to set the standards for everything that happens. Now, we do that in every other part of our business, so why not do it in spare parts inventory management? And I don't just mean high-level policies that have some motherhood statements about how we're going to do well. I mean policies and procedures that actually give our staff the information they need to make good decisions on a daily basis. We want to get things done consistently, and we want them done consistently well. Another thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to understand best practice. What are best practices in spare parts inventory management? What are the things that you really need to focus on? Well, not only will I explain in the book the best practices that you should follow, and there are five of them, I explain how we arrived at identifying those five best practices based on extensive research. Now, lastly, in establishing your spare parts inventory management system, you're going to need to be able to identify your spare parts. So how do you do that? How do you number your spare parts? How do you name your spare parts? We also address that in part one of this book.